A few years ago, South Korean brand Hyundai launched a luxury brand called Genesis, and if you weren't necessarily aware of that fact, that might be because they launched with three sedans right at a time when everybody was switching from sedans to crossovers and SUVs. Well, fast forward a couple of years, and now they've come up with this. This is the new 2021 Genesis GV80. It's the first crossover-style SUV from the brand. It's got turbocharged 4- and 6-cylinder engines. It's got rear or all-wheel drive, and look at the styling. It's meant to go up against vehicles like the Mercedes-Benz GLE, or the BMW X5, or the Lexus RX. Now, being the new kid on the block is kind of difficult in a luxury situation, so they really had to bring their A-game to make a splash. Well, we took one of these new GV80s out for a spin, and we can definitely tell you these established luxury brands had better be worried.
Let's start with the way it looks. It's incredibly distinctive, but it's different without being weird. It starts with the quad lamp setup in front, flanking that huge trapezoidal grille that features what Genesis calls their G-matrix look. Step back a pace and take it all in, and you'll realize that the front end mimics the Genesis winged shield logo in the shape of the grille on the headlights. The sides feature long character lines that stretch in unbroken curves to the rear, where the same quad light treatment is used on the LED taillights. The rear-wheel drive proportions of the GV80 are striking, with the overall look combining the more successful elements from Lincoln's latest showstoppers, Bentley's Bentayga, and some unique elements that are all Genesis's own look. It has exceptional presence on the street and is especially stunning in green or silver paint. The impressive looks carry over into the cabin, which finally showcases all that Hyundai and Genesis have learned about crafting luxury interiors. The materials in the GV80 are absolutely top-notch, easily on par with the best interiors in the luxury segment, and better than a lot of the supposedly top-tier luxury brands. I'm looking at you, Lexus. Genesis' special theme again revolves around that G-matrix look, represented in the interior by knurled metal patterning in just about every metal surface. Every knob has it, from the 4-way touch-sensitive multimedia selector to the climate controls to the electronic transmission gear selector. It's on the vent controls, the window switches, the volume knob on the steering wheel, the turn signal and wiper stalks. It lends an upscale texture and interest to the interior bits and pieces, and actually does help in gripping various surfaces when using them too. There are a few special items of note in the GV80's passenger compartment. Let's start with that unique steering wheel, which reminds me for all the world of the steering wheel on a 1992 Buick Roadmaster. That two-spoke, thick center look is definitely retro, but again, it's distinctive and unlike anything else you'll find in a modern luxury car. The other controls are a mix of dedicated buttons, like those that surround the climate control screen, and capacitive touch-sensitive ones, which the climate control system itself is. Unlike other luxury brands, however, Genesis hasn't gone overboard with touch-sensitive controls. It's limited to just a few operations of the climate control system, thankfully, and we can live with this. The round multimedia controller is also unique. It consists of a touch-sensitive round center panel and a knurled metal rotating ring, both of which are also 4-way controllers. It gives you a lot of flexibility in controlling the massive 14.5-inch multimedia screen, but if you don't want to use a remote controller, it's also a touchscreen, although some of it is a bit far from the driver to reach without a stretch. Much of it is also controllable via voice commands, which did seem to work quickly and without error when I tried them. The gauge cluster on most models is a reconfigurable mix of an analog speedometer and a digital display screen, and there's an optional heads-up display that's also big, bright, and easy to adjust. Spend some money on the top-tier trim, and you can get a nifty 3D display as well, which changes when you change drive mode and uses infrared cameras to track your eyes and adjust itself accordingly. Another special feature is the optional Lexicon Premium audio system, which features 21 speakers in 17 locations throughout the cabin, and 1,050 watts of power through 14 different channels. The system is absolutely dynamite, rivaling the Ravel system at Lincoln and the AKG Studio Reference system in the latest Cadillac Escalade for clarity, punch, and power. Now, this is a mid-sized crossover SUV and a rear-wheel drive one at that, so interior space suffers a bit from the packaging limitations of such a vehicle. You sit high in the GV80, but that does help for visibility. Front seat comfort is excellent, and the second row seats have adequate legroom, about what's expected for a mid-sized luxury crossover like this. There is a third row option, but it's only available on one specific trim level of the GV80, the V6 all-wheel drive Advanced Plus trim. And that's honestly okay. There's barely any room in the third row, it's suitable only for children. But it also highlights the cargo room of the GV80, which might be one of the few downsides of this vehicle. The liftover height to get cargo over the bumper feels quite high, and the cargo area floor itself also seems high, both likely a function of the GV80's rear suspension setup. But enough sitting and looking at the GV80, let's go somewhere. You have your choice of two powertrains for the new GV80, either a 300 horsepower turbocharged 2.5-liter four-cylinder engine, or a 375 horsepower twin-turbocharged V6. Both are mated to a standard 8-speed automatic transmission. The four-cylinder can be had with rear or all-wheel drive, while the V6 comes with all-wheel drive as standard. Either powertrain is a winner in my opinion, but I'd be hard-pressed to actually justify the extra cost of the V6 over the already outstanding performance of the four-cylinder. The Turbo 4 makes the GV80 quick and responsive, with the transmission shifting seamlessly and smoothly. You'll never lack for power when you want it, and it's quiet and placid at cruising speeds as well. The V6 has a little extra grunt, but it's just more for the sake of more. The standard engine is so good, splurging for the bigger one is really just a matter of prestige buying, or of picking a higher trim level so you can get more goodies. Ride quality is also excellent, even with the optional 22-inch wheels. 19-inch wheels are standard, and 20-inchers are available as well. The GV80 is definitely skewed more towards the luxury end of the luxury crossover SUV spectrum instead of the sporting end, and to me, that seems proper for a vehicle like this. I'll never understand why so many automakers are trying to turn tall, heavy wagons into sports models. Nobody drives these things aggressively, and nobody's taking one to a track day, so why not focus on making it cushy and comfortable instead? That's exactly what Genesis has done, crafting a beautifully premium driving experience with the GV80, one that focuses on control and refinement, but not isolation to the point of numbness as we've sometimes seen on other premium South Korean vehicles. Genesis's German executive influences are evident here, as a number of former BMW executives went to the brand several years ago, and have been rightly credited with crafting a premium rival to the traditional German luxury brands.
With its combination of style and top-notch interior luxury fittings and really state-of-the-art technology, the Genesis GV80 really does bring a competitive entry into the mid-sized luxury crossover SUV segment, which is exactly what it needs to do in order to be a success. If you'd like to learn more about the new 21 GV80 or any of the Genesis lineup, you can look everything up on Cars.com.